Hey guys, this is Nick and welcome to my Linux experiment. So there's been a bit of a controversy these last days on GTK theming. It seems that the GNOME GTK community is starting to realize that themes, as they are implemented right now, might actually be a bad thing. Let's dive into this. How GTK theming work. The GTK2 themes of yore could theme the window borders, the look of the controls such as buttons and scroll bars, and that was it. Applications used to be more simple, with less different resolutions to support, no high DPI, etc. This is why those themes worked pretty well and could be standardized. There were even theme managers and different theme engines back in the day. But with GTK3, there is an added layer of complexity. High DPI support, higher resolutions, more window and control states to support, there are a lot more things to consider while writing a theme. GTK3 uses CSS to style and theme applications. The problem is, the default GNOME theme, Advaita, or Advaita, I don't really know how you're supposed to pronounce it, is a core component of the GTK framework. That means that someone who wants to implement its own theme needs to copy the Advaita CSS and tweak it, or to override that CSS with their theme CSS and tweak it until everything works. Why is that a problem? Well, it means that if an app developer decides to implement a specific button style or to add some custom CSS style to his application, he will base himself on the Advaita stylesheet since it's the default core stylesheet. But if the user's or distro's custom theme overrides the Advaita stylesheet, there is no way for the developer to check if what he developed works or not with that modified style unless he tries his app with every single theme out there. So the problem deepens when you realize most distros that ship a GNOME and desktop don't ship the default version. Most distros implement their own themes, such as PopOS, Ubuntu with their community theme or Yaru theme, or Mint. So now, if you're developing a GTK app and want to use some custom styles, which is not that rare since all GTK3 apps are styled with CSS, you have to test that app on a number of systems to make sure that everything works with their custom themes. This quickly devolves into a maintenance hell for the developer and the distro, which has to constantly apply patches to the theme to support some app or another. It also means, more simply, that GNOME developers which update the Advaita stylesheet as a part of their desktop might break every theme by accident after each update. How does it work on elementary OS? Well, it works exactly the same. Elementary OS uses their own elementary stylesheet, which App Center apps can take advantage of. This means these apps will work perfectly fine on elementary, but might look absolutely broken on other platforms since they depend on the elementary stylesheet. That's why, if you change the theme with elementary tweaks, some elements might appear broken or with icons missing. The elementary stylesheet is already a modification of the Advaita stylesheet, which those other themes are trying to override. At this point, you would need elementary-specific themes that override the elementary stylesheet and not the Advaita one. You can see why this would be a problem if applied to every distro. So how do we move forward? Well, there are a few solutions. The first one would be to prevent distros from applying a theme altogether. This method seems too drastic to me. Distros are banned these days, and forbidding theming would be hard to do technically and a blow to each distro's identity. Ubuntu is known for its orange, Mint for its greens, etc. It would only encourage distros to fork DEs or hack them with terrible patches to make sure they could apply their own themes. It wouldn't solve the fragmentation problem, in my opinion, it would only make it worse. Another solution would be to implement a theming API or framework. The theme wouldn't be a complete CSS stylesheet, but would use some kind of format to override a few authorized items in the global stylesheet, such as colors, button shapes, padding, etc. This would ensure every theme would behave the same, since they could only modify the stylesheet through authorized means, and the app developer could take advantage of this API to apply the custom styles they need in their app, which would then take precedence over theme customizations to ensure everything works perfectly. This solution would be better in my opinion, but it will take a lot of time to implement, and upstream GNOME developers might not see the advantage for the platform to work on that. Their theme works, after all, and they are not responsible if things are broken by unsupported themes. With GTK Plus 4 around the corner, I doubt GNOME developers will take the time to implement something specifically for GTK 3. We'll see how this situation develops. I hope a compromise can be found and the situation can be resolved in the most user-friendly manner possible. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and bye! If you enjoyed, please consider liking, subscribing, and turning on notifications. You can also follow me on Twitter at @TheLinuxExp. Thank you guys for watching, and goodbye.